We get a lot of questions as to how you can customize Fireflies for your role and workflows. So in this walkthrough, we're going to see how Fireflies AI summaries blend into your day-to-day. So whether you're closing deals in sales, running HR interviews, guiding clients to investments as a financial advisor, or keeping accounts happy and customer success, you'll get a recap or a summary that's shaped to your workflow and role. So we look at picking up a template that makes sense for you, tweaking the sections you care about, and when things change, just regenerating or drilling deeper with a click. So let's jump in and make summaries truly yours. To customize the template, just go to the meeting in question. You can either access the meeting on your dashboard, or you can go to the meeting session and select the meeting. So let's say we want to customize the summaries for this particular meeting, the project Alpha Sync. Now, by default, every summary is a general summary. So it has a few sections here by default. So there's an overview. You can expand this. You can look into the transcript. Similarly, you will have some notes that are compartmentalized and neatly tied into bullet points. There will be timestamps that you can actually see where it's spoken about. In the end, you'll have final action items and next step that is assigned to a particular participant automatically. Now, if you want to customize this summary, you can go to the summary templates here. We have more than 80 templates to suit your role and workflow. So if you're in sales, you can use BANT or MEDDIC. If you are in finance, you can use tax planning, portfolio, and strategic check. You can use investment review meeting, or if you're a team leader, you can simply choose a team meeting or a one-on-one. So they have different sections that you can choose from and further customize them as well. Now, let's say I want to select the summary template for a one-on-one. It'll take up to a minute to generate this summary. So you have meeting summary for your one-on-one, which has a current focus area so that you can talk about certain projects that you're working on. There are some updates that are automatically neatly bulleted here. Then you have blockers, extremely important for a one-on-one meeting, especially with your reportees or with your team leader. And of course, the action items. Now you can further customize this like by going to the customize button right here. It will show you the connections that you have for these summary. So by default, it has three default sections. That is the current focus area, updates and blockers like how we saw. Action items is there regardless. We can also choose to have more sections based on the summary that we have highlighted or chosen. So object outline, topics, decisions, ideas, takeaways, so on and so forth. So we can select these and this will be added in your meeting summary. You have to note that it will come, every section, additional section will consume one AI credit. So please be mindful of that. If you have any active AI apps, you will see the AI app summary in your summaries right below. So for example, I have one for financial decisions. So this is where you see the AI app summary. Now, there are a few things that you can do and play around with. You can edit these summaries based on how you want to frame it. You can copy paste. You can also move a certain section based on your preference. Now, once you select a particular template, you will see an option to auto-apply to every meeting. So you can choose to either keep this active. That means all your new meetings or future meetings will have a summary based on your selection, or you can just have a summary for one particular meeting. So you can just check this off. So let's just say that you're not too happy with a summary. You want to tweak it further, or you want it to be regenerated. You can simply go to these three dots and select an option to regenerate notes here, and it will regenerate your summary. This is also helpful when you have edited the speaker label so that your speakers get updated on your summary itself. And that's about it. These custom-made templates will save you a lot of time the next time, so try it out and let us know how you like it.